So welcome to this class of artificial intelligence. In this class we will discuss about fuzzy logic. And before we discuss about fuzzy logic, we will have to discuss the basics which are used in fuzzy logic. And the first thing in that basic is fundamentals of fuzzy logic is fuzzy sets. So we have been studying sets, conventional sets. Now let us see that what are fuzzy sets. Once we are clear about fuzzy sets, then we'll be able to understand the method to use this fuzzy set to apply to solve the practical problems using fuzzy sets. And then we apply fuzzy logic for that, where we have rules and those rules are applied to solve a given problem. So first of all, let us see the classes of objects which we find in the real world, real physical world. Then we will see that the classes of objects in the real physical world more often don't have precisely defined criteria of membership. Now we need to explore that, what we mean by that they don't have precisely defined criteria of membership. So for that we can see one example. So this example is about the class of animals. And if you think of the class of animals, then you can, if I ask that, is dog a member of that class? Then answer will be clear cut yes. Horses, birds. So they are clearly included in this class of animals. They all are members of this class. But if we go to objects such as starfish, bacteria, and so on, there are other examples also, then with respect to this class of animals, these objects have got ambiguous status. So this is one example of this case where certain objects don't have a clear-cut membership in that. Their membership is ambiguous. Their status in that class is ambiguous. Another very good example is the status of a number such as 10. The status of this number in a class which we are telling that this class is of all real numbers which are much greater than 1. So this class which I am taking here is class of all such real numbers which are much greater than 1. Now what is the status of this number 10 in this class? Is it belonging or is it a member of this class? So such is an example where we are not able to precisely define the criteria of membership. Now similarly other exam classes are there. So for example, class of all real numbers which are much greater than 1. This we have seen. Similarly, the class of Ptolemy. This class, if you consider and you can take a person, then most of the persons whom you find tall, others may not find tall. Their perceptions may be different. So, such examples do not constitute classes or sets in the usual mathematical sense of these terms. So when we say usual mathematical sense, then we mean that these sets, usual mathematical definition of these sets is that a given member belongs to this particular class or it doesn't belong to it. So it's very, very clear. But these examples which we have discussed, here we find that their status becomes ambiguous. These imprecisely defined classes, which we have taken few examples, they play an important role in the human thinking we can find around us, in our thinking, in our languages, such kind of descriptions, and those particularly in the domain of pattern recognition, communication of information, and abstraction. These examples we will see in later course of this course. Now comes the term fuzzy set with these definitions, with these examples. So now we can talk about a set which is able to include these members where their status is going to be ambiguous. So we are trying to define a set which we are calling as fuzzy set. As it is given here, fuzzy set is a class with a continuum of grades of membership. This is important. Grades of membership. And the notion of a fuzzy set, which we are going to discuss with this background, is a conceptual framework which provides a natural way of dealing with problems in which source of imprecision, as we have discussed here in the previous examples, there is imprecision. So source of imprecision is the absence of sharply defined criteria of class members. The previous examples I have highlighted this. So source of imprecision means imprecision is there. And what is the source of imprecision? Source of imprecision is absence of this criteria, which sharply defines the membership, rather than the presence of random variable. So here we are trying to clarify that the situation, the case which we are taking, is not related to random variables. Rather, imprecision is not due to random variable. Rather, imprecision is there because this criteria to sharply define the membership in a particular class, that criteria is absent. So this point which we have discussed here is very important, because sometimes there is a confusion regarding fuzzy set and random variables or probabilities. So here that is being emphasized, that source of imprecision is not due to random variables, is not due to presence of random variables. Rather, this source of imprecision is because there is absence of sharply defined criteria using which membership of any object can be defined in a class. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the definitions of fuzzy sets. Thank you.